Hi guys, welcome to Let's Get to the Marks. Today we're looking at the life cycle of stars as it's known in AQA GCSE, or stellar evolution as it's known in IGCSE physics. Both cover the same content, so don't worry which you're doing. Here before you, you see dust and gas in the far reaches of the universe coalescing together to form stars. In this presentation, we're going to go through all the stages in a star's life. Stage 1. Stars initially form from clouds of dust. We call these nebula. Here in the second stage, the dust and gas particles from the nebula are pulled together by gravity. The particle collision causes a rise in temperature. Eventually, the heat is high enough for nuclear fusion to take place. This is where hydrogen nuclei slam together at tremendous speed to form a helium nuclei and release tremendous amounts of energy. This energy forms a hot core and a protostar is born. So the second stage of a star's life is the formation of a protostar. The third stage of a star's life, the longest stage, is called the main sequence. Normally this stage lasts for billions of years, but in very big stars, they burn through the fuel quickly and their main sequence is shorter. As you see here in this picture, we're going to look at why the star doesn't collapse or doesn't expand. Why is it stable for a long period? Well, the nuclear fusion in the star's core creates an outward pressure shown here by the black arrows. This outward pressure is equaled by the gravitational attraction trying to collapse the star. Therefore, as these arrows are equal, the star neither collapses or expands, it stays stable. Here in the fourth stage of a star's life, the hydrogen in the core begins to run out. This means there's less nuclear fusion in the core and the outward pressure shown by the black arrows is smaller. It's now outweighed by the gravitational force of attraction shown here with the green arrows. This means the star begins to collapse. As it shrinks, it has a smaller volume, so it heats up. It then expands its outer layers, becoming something we know as a red giant. In this fourth stage is where we get the divergence between stars the same size as our Sun and supermassive stars. The stars the same size as our Sun become red giants, and stars much bigger than our Sun become super red giants. During this phase, the star is cooler, hence its red color, which is of a lower frequency than the color blue or violet. The star has run out of hydrogen, and so is forced to fuse helium. It can force elements all the way to iron, and the elements shown here, circled in red, are the elements stars can form in the red giant phase. The fifth stage for stars are Sun size. They now eject their outer layers and leave behind a dense core. They are now called a white dwarf. Although only theoretical at this time, it is believed that stars like our Sun, when they're in the white dwarf phase, they will cool down and stop emitting light altogether. At this point, they will become black dwarfs. However, the universe is not old enough yet for any of its stars to have reached the black dwarf phase. For stars much bigger than our Sun, there is a totally different fate awaiting. For massive stars, the fifth stage results in an explosion called the supernova. During this explosion, elements heavier than iron will be formed from fusion. And these elements will go on to form new planets and new stars. Elements like silver and gold are formed in these final stages of a massive star's life. In the final stage of a massive star's life, it will form a dense neutron star or a super dense object we call a black hole. A black hole has such a strong gravitational pull that even light cannot escape. A neutron star is not quite as dense, but it is still dense enough that the gravitational pull will pull the electrons from the orbitals of its atoms into its nuclei and fuse with the protons, forming neutrons. A neutron star is purely made of neutrons. Okay, we're now going to look at the overall map of the star's life. You need to learn this off by heart for your exams. It could well come up in your physics exam, either for AQA or IGCSE Edexcel. We can see here that the stages of a star's life are exactly the same, stage 1, 2, and 3, for both supermassive stars and stars the size of our sun. But it's at stage 4, when they enter the red giant or super red giant, that their lives go in different directions. So what's going to happen now? You're going to get a series of exam questions on this presentation. These are taken from real exam papers. So pause the video when the question comes up, have a go, and then unpause to check your answers. All right, guys, that's all from me. Let's get to the marks. Thank you.